Good evening, Free Enterprise, and welcome to the Monday Night Community Race. And tonight we have the Beginner Bonanza with a little taste of Hades for our objectives tonight. Hopefully our runners have their fists tuned up, their bows all set, and their exogryphs loaded. I'm Bad Karma, and I'm joined in the booth tonight, making their commentary debut with Lady SSJ Zunigears. How you doing tonight?
I'm doing very good, Bad Karma. Thank you for the introduction. I'm excited to be commentating for tonight. What do you think about these objectives for tonight?
Oh, we got these are some good ones, you know. We got a little bit of everything. We got some key item hunts with that hook and rat tail. We gotta get a Baron key, and we gotta get to the underground. Maybe early pass might not even need to go to the moon.
I like the Legend Sword with Adamant. That was a staple during the Highway to the Threema Zone tournament runs, wasn't it?
Yes, it was, and it's been a staple, I believe, for a lot of the tournaments because it's a really good objective because it's two items that don't have to lead to anything, so they could just be anywhere.
And the good thing about that is I feel that, you know, because you're going to be getting that Legend Sword and Adamant, you're going to be forging that X-Cal, you're also going to be getting access to that Kokol shop, which will have, on this flag set, you know, a little bit better gear to potentially buy anyway. Potentially, I say.
Yep, and we should be getting underway. Hopefully we will see some good gear in that Kokol shop. And do you want to give a quick shout out to our restreamer Dathis, our tracker Moonblaze Wolf, who will be keeping us honest tonight as well. And on the screen, we have Commander Leonhart, Poorly Drawn Bees, Scythe Marshal, and Zoe Vermillion.
Yes, very much thanks to them for agreeing to be restreamed.
Got Rydia Rosa start with a sand ruby. This is that's a really good start, I feel like, with these two characters to be able to get that third character really quickly.
Yeah, absolutely. Knowing that you can just dive and check that character immediately, I mean, that's just fantastic.
The interesting thing will be when to choose to go with that character set, because we don't have any free characters, we don't have any free key items, so we'll be looking for that Demas tonight as well. With these two characters, I could see a couple of our players just going straight there.
Oh, I would. That would be the first place I'd go. I also hunt for some bosses, to, like you said, to try to find that Demas.
Oh, there's a Fuso Ya sitting in the Baron Inn.
Oh, that is very nice. Although it is not Vanilla Fu, we should note. So you do have to get him online, which means beating bosses, which isn't a bad thing, but, you know, he's not going to start out with his full spell set. He's not going to start out with Nuke, most importantly.
Yeah, and that Sand Ruby character was a Porum, so we got all the ladies in the party tonight. A lot of divergence here. We got Zoe going into the Watery Pass, trying to take advantage of this T-Wildish flag set. A lot of good loot can be found there. And we've got Commander Leonhart heading to check out that Hob Summon for this Rydia.
Unfortunately, not going to be finding anything all that valuable in that.
Yeah, haven't seen anything pop up too big. Had a miss summon there for the Rydia for Commander Leonhart. Ooh, Artemis arrows. That'll be nice if we can get a good bow to go with that.
Yeah, I'm watching the loot too, and not seeing anything too, you know, outstanding. T Wildish is very nice, but, you know, also it's sparse 80%, which means that 20% of these chests are going to be empty.
And we do need to remember with T Wireless, it's kind of weighted a little bit with these, so it's similar weighting to the T Pro. So the later checks or the out of the way checks, like the waterway, are gonna definitely have a higher chance of getting this loot. As we're seeing poorly drawn bees getting the hovercraft raised up and out of the way.
Yeah, I mean, you know you're gonna have to do it. You know, you're gonna have to trade away that rat tail, so you might as well just do it while you're there. You do it so you don't forget. You know, that you don't forget later, essentially. I mean, you know, for me, I like just getting this stuff that's obvious out of the way early so you don't have to come back later to do it.
And one of the best pieces of loot was found, the Thunderclaw, and there was a Zeus Gauntlet in that waterfall. I don't believe Zoe went that deep.
Yeah, she may not have chosen to because... you know, that the fact that you don't have exit, the fact you don't have exit, you figure, okay, well, I'm just not going to dive it.
That was a Fusoya on Mount Hobbs. We could have two foos for this beginner's bonanza here, with the foo waiting for our runners in the Baron Inn.
Oh, getting lucky with the sylph summon there too of your grimoire.
Yeah, and the foos don't need bosses for each of them. You kill one boss, both foos are gonna start getting their spells. That's gonna be a really great way to slingshot this group with this sea relax flag, giving our runners some easy goings, it looks like, character wise.
Commander does pick up a self-summon from the Mist Village, so that's a very good pickup for that Rydia.
Yeah, we do have the sylph glitch on, so as long as that Rydia is not in the middle slot, then that self-summon won't cost any magic once the Rydia has enough MP to be able to do that cast. But Rydia still needs 25 MP just to be able to do it.
That is a very good point, yes.
Our tracker pointing out that Fu's looter staff is nothing to discount. The old man can shake a stick and can make pretty good work until he gets some spells.
Yeah, 500 HP, I believe, base starting, so... Yeah, I mean, even if you just need someone as a meat shield, certainly works very well.
Commander Leonhard is cleared out the Mist Cave. That was a pale dim, I believe.
Well, at the very least, it's one more boss to get Foo, online. Does he actually have a Foo in his party? I don't know if he does.
He has not gone to Hobbs yet to see that there's another Foo up there, but I believe he peeked the Baron Inn, so he knows there's one easily available.
Good thing is that the bosses you defeat will count towards Foo unlocking their spells, you know, no matter when you decide to get that Foo.
Ooh, Zoe with the nice rolls on the Grimoire got a Ramu for the first one. Odin for the second one. That second phase of that Dark Elf fight is does not have the boss bit on, so that instant death attack made really short work.
Very much so. That is beyond, I want to say beyond lucky, but that is very nice to see.
We got Commander Leonhart and Scythe Marshall are both heading down into the Antlion Cave. This is one of the easier checks. A lot of first boss kills here in the Antlion Cave to get this key item. So we'll see who's hanging out down here.
Yeah, it's an easy check. You know the boss only has 1,000 HP. You get it done now. It's one of those that, you know, at least maybe if you're a newer runner, if you don't do it now, you're going to have a tendency to forget about it. So you might as well just do it. Like you said, it's an easy key item check.
It gets that Rydia up to that 25 MP threshold too, to be able to use the Sylph Summon.
course, not the easiest boss you want to see in that plague.
Well, there is a samurai bow actually hanging out in the antlion cave.
Well, and 800 damage plus 800 damage from that Rosa plus that self summon's going to make very quick work of that plague.
Plague is a flying monster, so those bows doing the double damage for the racial, you know, and also having Artemis arrows, that not surprised with that 800.
I was going to say, you see Zoe looting this mist cave. You know, the reason is, you know, on the T Wildish, you have, I believe, it's a low chance, but it's still a chance of pulling, you know, higher tier items. I think you can pull tier 6 items, you know, like I said, albeit a low chance, but still it's a chance.
It is one of the more out of the way checks. So getting some of your higher gear will definitely be have a chance. I know I've pulled a rune axe out of Mist Cave on T Wildish. I've pulled, you know, a couple other little nice things to just kind of speed you along on the seed. So if you pull that hook in that antlion, how does that make you feel, Lady SSJ? You know, getting that hook, you've got these party members, you've got another foo waiting for you in Baron Inn.
I don't like it, to be honest. I don't like pulling the early hook. You know, give me a magma key. I'd rather have that be my underground access. You know, having that hook just makes me just afraid of who is going to be at that, you know, those two upper Babel spots.
Yeah, I my early times, the hook route was definitely something that I had to struggle hard on. We're getting a CPU as a second fight here. This is going to be a little, this is a doable fight here, but it's going to take a bit.
Yeah, CPU is always doable. It's just how long, you know, how much of your life are you going to spend to try to beat it down? You know, luckily, Commander's got that self-summon, which is just really doing some work for him.
And Poorly Drawn Bees is going to be heading down this hook route and give us a look at see who this character is and what bosses could possibly await our runners.
You know, if nothing else, you get the character. You know, if you know, I don't know if there are any more overworld checks for bees, but like I said, if nothing else, you get the character check. If it's somebody you know you want, you take them. Maybe you die Babel, and if it's something you can't handle, you back out.
Yeah, we still have our deals in Babel. Nobody has gone up the mountain yet. Just Hobbs. So I would like to maybe get the foo a little bit more powered up with some of these easier bosses. There's a Yang.
You have that evil wall waiting for you down below, and that and this early, I want nothing to do with that evil wall.
That the evil wall at the Rubicante spot does not spark joy.
No, it does not. I will exhaust every other option before trying to take down that evil wall.
I would probably make a visit to Castle Eblin in hopes of maybe pulling a Moonveil out of there with this T-Wildish flag set. We have a Mom Bomb in the Fabul defense. That Mom Bomb, it, no matter where I find Mom Bomb, is my least favorite boss.
Yeah, I would tend to agree. It doesn't matter where she comes from. Very rarely, you know, does it find that you'll take her down before she puffs up and explodes, you know, then, you know, explodes into the six, and then usually you don't have any kind of AoE to deal with them. And it's just, it's kind of like dealing with CPU. It's doable. It just takes forever.
Yeah, and we only have a basic starter kit, so some of the J items that, you know, we would like to see, maybe a Boreas or a Zeus Rays, to really just knock these out real fast. But Fu gets it done, though.
B's having a little bit of a tough time, though, with those two stalemen now. I'm going to have to take an unfortunate reset out of that.
Yeah, the stalemen chest is surprise. Oh, wow.
Oh, and there's our darkness crystal. Oh, my goodness. How does that make you feel?
Oh, man. Early darkness crystal is the bane of my existence. Because there are just so many routing decisions, you know, in the early game you're making that, you know, you kind of want to do your progression and your checks and, you know, get a feel for the seed. Getting that darkness crystal early like this will throws me off personally.
Oh, I would tend to agree. I mean, between having the hook, I mean, you know, Commander has the hook. He's got the darkness crystal.
There's our darkness crystal.
Let's put it this way. I'm glad I am, you know, commentating this and not racing this race tonight. I want nothing to do with this.
But equally is interesting, Zoe Vermillion just pulled the spoon. Finding Edward, we do have the spoon flag on. Adamant armors are available in the seed, so could have a fully online spoon ward.
Yeah, that's very true. Maybe if you get down to, you know, Dwarf Castle, maybe pull him there. I mean, for me, I'd like to pull him early rather than try to get him online late, but that's just my personal, you know, take on Edward.
So with the hook and now the darkness crystal, we're two items away from go mode. You know, we just need that rat tail and that baron key.
Well, we need the legend sword, right? We still need adamant.
Yeah, you're right. I totally forgot about objective number one.
We're used to the three-minute zone where it was, you know, complete three of four objectives and everyone seemed to skip objective one.
Yeah, so we do need all four objectives to get our crystal. So our runners are going to... Oh, there's sirens there in the Eblin Cave Shop.
Oh, that is fantastic. You know, where would you... You know, I know what my preferred spot, you know, would be to use them. You know, where would you think you'd use them, you know, if you're one of these runners?
Early game, definitely, if you can find at least one or two coffins, is go crack an egg once you get underground. We have Artemis arrows and a samurai bow for a couple of our runners. So that is, eggs are still very, very doable with an Artemis bow, Artemis arrows. That would be my first stop for sure, as soon as I would hit underground, if I had five characters that I wanted to get some levels on.
Oh, absolutely. Even if you pick up somebody from Dwarf, you know, that you want to get online. I mean, you know, say you pick up, you know, I'm trying to think, you know, if you pick up, I don't even know, maybe a Palum, but yeah, you pick up a Palum, crack an egg and you get Quake.
Yep, it does need two eggs to get the Quake from a vanilla, unless there's this little slingshot going on. But yes, a Palum would be great to have there. I would even take a Cecil if I went up Ordeals first. We have had our runners all really avoiding Ordeals because they haven't seen a Cecil or Tella.
Yeah, and that's another thing too. It's, you know, you fade Ordeals, and then it's something that, you know, unless you get that Cecil, you know, or Tella, you may forget about, you know, until later. You know, that's something that's bitten me before. Like I said, with some of these early checks, you're used to doing the Ordeals, you're used to doing Antlion early. You forget about them, and then you're looking for some key item. And, you know, turns out it's in one of those early locations that you faded.
And we're talking about fading Ordeals as Commander Leonhart is making the climb. Once they get that foo powered up, I don't believe Commander Leonhart has gone to Hobbs to see that there's a second foo.
Well, right, and this is good. You're right, because this is three bosses here, so that's three, you know, spots to power that foo up.
Especially with an evil wall looming in that hook route, you haven't found a magma key. We haven't found any other progression. If my choice is between evil wall and the Rubicon spot or going to the moon, I'm going to want to take those sirens somewhere.
Oh, absolutely. And the only reason I go to the moon at this point is to check the character, and then I'm coming back.
Got poorly drawn bees working on the mom bombs at Fabul as Zoe has finished with the CPU fight.
Yep, and Commander going to be making short work of that antlion in the first ordeal spot.
Just some vampires up in the moonshop that could be useful. We have a number of runners. We have 20, I believe. 20, how many? 21 runners tonight. A number of them do like using Edward and 1200 HP strats. So those vampires could be useful later on.
That's very true. It depends on where the seed takes you. You know, I have a feeling with these objectives, though, that, you know, that may not be on the table. I think you're going to find that you're going to get your characters powered up to where that, you know, may not be a, you know, on the table, but we'll see as Scythe gets a Cid at the Lunar Dais.
Hey, the Moon Engineer has a hammer, and he's all right taking some damage against Evil Walls.
Yeah, Scythe was debating about, you know, whether to have that Porum go away, but I think you have that Rosa, you know, you get a, you know, a Cid that has, 700 HP or so to start out with, so you got someone that can actually, you know, tank some more damage, so I think this is the right move to make.
Yeah, and it has an Earth Hammer. That is one of Cid's better weapons, especially against, you know, those alerts down in Lower Babel. Get some really quick trap chest clear outs.
Yeah, and as chat kind of points out for us, that back attack ordeal spot is a free boss, so, you know, good for Commander.
Side Marshal going into the Cave Bahamut. Maybe doing some looting, maybe get some scouting going.
It is an interesting choice. You know, there aren't a lot of chests to pick up out of here, but, you know, maybe figures, well, okay, I could just peep that boss, and maybe if it's like a water hag, I can just quickly, you know, maybe just try to just burn it down real quick and get some early XP. But seeing that Val there, I don't think they're going to be doing that one.
That is anything but free.
We see Commander Leonhard getting through that back attack spot, just going to be going right into ordeals. I'm going to be getting that key item first.
Yep, we got poorly drawn bees and Zoe Vermilion are going to be joining Commander on the ordeals mountain.
Yeah, you imagine they feel the same way, that just avoid that, you know, avoid that hook route as Commander picks up the tower key and is going to be fighting some three imps.
That is, oh wow, this was a very free ordeals. You know, I mean, Antlion in the Mylon and Friend spot, not terrible. With all the magic we have, definitely pretty free. But then going into King, Queen, and then Dark Imps here, that's a free ordeals.
Yeah, I mean, as a you know, a newer player, you know, so far this hasn't been too rude. You know, like I said, these are definitely bosses you would want to see. You know, as opposed to some of the other ruder bosses that could definitely be, you know, in these ordeal spots.
Yeah, and all of our runners definitely thinking the same thing. All four of our restream runners on Mad Ordeals right now. Oh, that was Nuke for Commander Leonhard.
Well, then that just gets him online, and that just now all of a sudden makes that hook route just, you know, doesn't make it free, but it makes it a heck of a lot easier.
Yeah, get some blinks on that foo. Two foos with Nuke this early, yeah. Unless that Val is required.
Well, if that Val's required, then yeah, then we're in for a fun time.
So while we do have our runners kind of all doing the same checks, as Commander Leonhard is gonna head out, maybe check the moon character, maybe dive that hook route. Do want to do a quick shout out to the Restream team, you know, Dathis for rolling this fine, fine seed that we are witnessing. Moonblaze Wolf pushing all the buttons, keeping us honest up here. And to my co-commentator, Lady SSJ, for making things exciting in the booth.
Yes, thank you very much. You know, definitely a fun seed to co-commentate. And yeah, this would not be at all possible for me or any of us to do this without the Free Enterprise community, you know, backing it. You know, this community is one of the best to be a part of. So, you know, if you're interested, certainly, you know, go to the website. If that's, you know, that could be linked, and then, you know, load up a seed of your own and, you know, give this a try.
Yeah, I'm part of a number of different randomizer communities. Free Enterprise is definitely one of the best that I've been a part of in my short time with them.
Yeah, same. You know, very inclusive community, very helpful, very friendly to newcomers. You know, there's a lot to like.
And as Pepita in chat just noticed, we do have a recently new emote with the Free Enterprise channel. So if you are a subscriber, been gifted a subscription, you can get that free hug.
Yes, definitely very cute. I love it.
Looks like Commander Leonhart taking his nuke and heading right for the King Queen spot. Has exhausted all of his overworld checks. Wants to get underground to use that tower key, do his objectives.
Well, it's the only thing you have left. You know, I think you do it first. You should be able to do it with that Foo and that Rydia, you know. Hopefully without having to, you know, grind for any XP.
But let's see what the first order of business. It is a purple robe.
It is a Mylon and friend. So, you know, those lit ones that'll be coming from Mylon, and every time you hit him will be annoying, but he'll get through this fight no problem.
Everybody else is finishing up on ordeals. Zoe trying to figure out which way to go.
Now, as you look at these runners, you know, I guess you would have to say Commander's kind of got the, you know, maybe kind of the lead at the moment. I mean, he's got both the Darkness and Tower Key, you know, and he's the first one to go, you know, through the hook route.
Yeah, but our runner, the Scythe Marshal and Zoe have both been to the moon, did a little scouting, got that Sid. Zoe has also done Fabul. So it is very hard to tell, but we know that, you know, Fabul only had a spoon, so, and Commander Leonhart will do it eventually. So definitely has an edge here. Oh no.
Oh. What is going on here? Do you want to explain this?
Yes. So if you kill Mylon before you kill his friends get very punchy. Instead of using a very low spell power drain on you, they have a very high attack power hit. And I do not recommend killing Mylon before you kill his friends.
I will be perfectly honest. I have killed Mylon before, and I've just been able to kill the other ones quickly enough to not see that. So that is good knowledge to have. Do not kill Mylon first.
And now let's see if how Commander Leonhart wants to tackle this evil wall.
Well, starting with a nuke is a good way, but he does have a lot of HP, so it's going to take more than one.
Yeah, roughly about 25,000-ish, give or take. So a couple nukes are going to be needed to get through this.
You wonder if he's just going to try to just, you know, power his way through this with nukes. Fortunately, that Rydia just has such low HP.
And Poorly Drawn Bees, I don't know if you caught that, was able to get a nuke off on the CPU before the wall went up.
Oh, that saves a lot of time then. That's very good.
Oh, this is... Ooh!
Yeah, that's unfortunate. I mean, to be honest, it's the same thing. I would have done the same thing. You know, you don't want to have to try to grind. But now you see Commander Leonhard backing out. Maybe we'll try to go after that Mad Ogre chest. You know, we do have the life glitch on. So you can get, you know, double XP for Mad Ogres that you kill.
Yeah, that would be my stop. Go look for that chest. That's a good infusion of XP for this level, and you know, getting your health levels up to be able to take a hit. Fu won't get any levels, but at least you know your Rosa might get Blink, might be able to get Berserk. Yang will get some XP, might be able to take a hit.
You know, unfortunately, though, those Mad Ogres still punch a hit, so you still have to kind of survive it. So he may not be able to get the life glitch off. You know, he may just be about just powering through this just to be able to get them down.
And as Commander is going to be working on these Mad Ogres, Zoe is taking on Mylon and friends.
Well, that Quake will ensure that they do not run into the same, you know, situation that Commander did.
Got the size off, so Commander's gonna have a free Mad Ogre fight now.
Ah, yes, indeed.
They take extra damage while they're small, so Commander Leonhart will be able to take his time. Get them killed, get these life glitches off, and hopefully get enough XP to get through the evil wall as Zoe Vermillion is starting up on the evil wall.
Yeah, we have Zoe going after evil wall, and we have Poorly Drawn Bees going in Eblin and doing these trap chests, you know, maybe hoping for an infusion of XP, maybe hoping for some, you know, higher tiered loot.
I think with this party, my wish list item to be finding in Eblin would definitely be a Moonveil.
Now, I personally have not used the Moonveils that much. You want to explain a little bit about why that would be a good find?
Yeah, so the Moonveil is a really nice item because it not only gives you the Reflect status, but it also gives you another status effect. This, like I believe it's called Barrier, where it negates all physical attacks as well. So since that's all the evil wall does is physical attacks and counters with the stone attack, then you know his physical attack won't do anything until he gets close enough to start going into crush phase. So you would hope that if you throw a moon veil on your foo, he will be able to nuke the evil wall down before he gets to that point. Would be my strategy looking for that.
We have Zoe with these two foos just, you know, back-to-back nuke casts. Hopefully we'll be through this soon. And there goes the shake, and Zoe's through that evil wall. First one through, you know, to get to the underground.
Yep, and Poorly Drawn Bees found a Murasame. So if we find an edge, that'll be a nice little weapon for him to be able to use. Got Rubikante here in the waterfall spot, trying to get more spells for Scythe Marshal's foos. That was an Octomammoth as our required boss of the lower Tower of Babel. I would almost be tempted to come out of this with the Falcon and just immediately land and head right up the tower before doing anything else. That's going to be two checks. Octomammoth at that spot with these two foos so powered. We'll be having calamari for dinner.
I would agree. I don't like doing Keyless Tower, but the fact that you have the key and you're right there, although Zoe opts to go, I don't know if they're just going to go heal and then go, or maybe they're going to go to Dwarf Castle.
I don't mind the heal. The party took a lot of damage, want to get that MP back. Food does not have a lot of MP, 190, and Nuke takes 50 MP to cast, so looks like Fee is heading right back to the tower, though, after the heal.
Yeah, like you said, it's the right call, I think, to make. You know, you get your tower check out of the way. You know, you go to top, you take care of that, you do the cannon room, two key item checks, and then you don't ever have to come back here again.
Commander Leonhart taking another fight, looking for a little bit more XP.
Yeah, unfortunately, not having the knowledge that we and the rest of the other runners have, that there is a second foo available. It's probably the right choice to make with this party. That one nuke a piece isn't going to be enough to, get that evil wall down.
Yep, and we have Scythe Marshall doing some shopping in the Eblin shop. Poorly Drawn Bees going to be doing some inventory management with all that newfound Castle Eblin loot.
They pick up the Crystal Sword from Eblin. I didn't see where they got the Crystal Sword from.
I think it was one of the Eblin items. The Crystal Sword in Castle Eblin has been is definitely something on T-Wildish that I've seen a number of times. That has made a seed for me a whole lot more bearable if we can find that, Cecil.
Absolutely.
I missed if that's exactly where she got it from, because I did see the Ninja Hat and the Murasame. I did not see what was the Staleman Skeleton Chest. I was watching Zoe Vermillion roast an evil wall.
And Commander gets through those Mad Ogres, gets a couple more levels, gets blank, which I think is the most important out of all that, and picks up a Strength Ring.
Now, are you a fan of Calamari? Because Zoe just made some for us, a little marinara, dip it in, a little butter.
I am very much a fan of calamari, so thank you very much, Zoe, for serving that up to us.
In the Twin Harp, so could have some music in our future, depending on if Zoe wants to give it to us. And Zoe's also the first one on the board by completing that boss at the top of Lower Babel.
Yes, very true. Very true. And we get elements in the cannon room spot. Seems threatening, but not at all, because it's a low HP spot.
Low HP. Nuke will completely overkill. Now, I'm personally a fan of do your freebies, do your objectives, do your freebies. I would think that Zoe's probably going to head into Fey March, get that freebie chest down there. That's where I would probably tend to go.
Yeah, as a relatively, new runner, I have definitely been burned by the, avoiding your freebies, avoiding your objectives. It never hurts to chase your objectives. If anything, you get objectives done. If it leads to a dead end, so be it. But, you're doing an objective and, you're potentially getting a key item out of the process. So, yeah, absolutely. Chase your objectives.
Yeah, and I liked the idea of waiting to go to Sylph until you've done some of these checks in the underground, just in case you find that pan. Because then you don't have to double dip Sylph.
Self is always one I will do last for that reason, too. The worst feeling in the world is pulling the pan out of one of these other underground checks, knowing you could have gotten it first.
And Commander Leonhart is going in for round two on the Evil Balls.
And speaking of pan, Zoe picks up a pan from that cannon room key item check, so good for Zoe.
Always check your objectives. Always check your freebies. That is one of the reasons right there on why you would want to do that.
Yeah, it's very nice to see on display why it's a good thing to check your objectives. Meanwhile, we have Commander giving this Evil Wall another shot. Has that blink up on Fu, has another nuke going off, but has two party members down. I'm not sure how much damage they've done to it already.
And while the eyes were on Commander Leonhart, that was an Earth Crystal in the Feymarch chest with a T-Wildest treasury in our future, quite possibly, depending on how much looting Zoe Vermillion wants to do.
Now, that is interesting because, because of the T-Wildest flag, you're going to see those higher tier items. But, you know, you wonder if that T-Sparse flag maybe turns people maybe just enough away because 20% of that could be empty or maybe more. It's not going to be a completely full treasury, not to take the, wind out of the sails of the treasury, but it is something to consider.
And unfortunately, Commander Leonhart takes another death to the Evil Wall, as Zoe also gave us a look at the Feymarch bosses. That was a Bigan in the Leviathan spot and a Demist in the Asura spot.
Those are spots, if I'm a runner, I'm going to be fading until the bitter end. You know, my party will be in the 50s, high 40s, 50s before I will bother attempting those.
Yeah, the Demist is interesting, especially with the two Foos, because while that is the fastest spot in the game, and that Demist is going to be shifting real quick, the nukes from the Foos will make pretty short work of it. That's one of the things I struggled when I was first learning the game and learning to race, was when I had the tools to tackle certain bosses. And I've learned that there are a number of bosses at that Asura spot that are deceptively hard, but it is always going to come down to what you have the tools. And two Foos is going to make short work of pretty much everything in the underground.
Absolutely, but those bosses will still hit pretty hard. So, like you said, they can be deceptive. So you would think two Foos, nukes, but, a couple punches from Bigan, unless you get those blinks off, will still be an issue.
Zoe is going to go turn in the pan. I did not see what was the reward for knocking Yang on the head.
Chad is saying crystal armor.
Sheila, on the other hand, to go with that crystal armor, gave a legend sword.
Well, that is one half of an objective, so that is required.
Package, it's a key item. I don't think we'll probably see any of our runners be burning the village mist. We've got two Foos. Who else would you want other than maybe Cecil to help out? But he's not even required.
Now, if I see that Cecil, maybe if you're one of these runners, you say, all right, well, I'm good with my party for now. And if I want Cecil, maybe I take him later. Either use as an anchor or, maybe use slingshot.
Great!
Maybe, I'm also, you know, very much biased towards Crystal Sword Cecil, so I would also maybe go after that Cecil early.
And that treasury had an adamant and a Stardust Rod.
Best treasury, then. Best treasury. Well worth it. I mean, what are the chances of pulling that adamant armor out? It's higher with T Wildish, but it's still pretty low.
Yeah, adamant armor is considered a tier 7 piece, so it is anywhere there's tier 7 loot, the adamant armor can appear, I believe.
Let me see, Scythe going after Evil Wall. We'll probably have, you know, an easier time with the two foos. Commander still plugging away. Hopefully can get through this with maybe one more nuke.
The question in chat, there are 7 tiers of loot. And Zoe is giving us the harp music.
For the people.
So can you explain why this is Zoe is being a runner for the people right now?
So, you know, anyone who's familiar with the vanilla game, you know, normally you get the Dark Elf, you have the harp. You know, first you get into the fight with Dark Elf. Dark Elf taunts you, hits you hard. You know, it's a scripted lose fight. And then after that, you know, it flash forwards to Eddie in the bed at Troia. Eddie going to harp, and then we'll play one of, you know, randomized songs that, you know, have been composed specifically, you know, for this. And they can just be from, you know, you name it, Final Fantasy games, from Chrono Trigger. I saw one from Wild Arms earlier today. But, you know, they're all good and they're all amazing.
So we will sit back and relax and listen to the sounds of DJ Spoony B. And Zoe is through with an alt gauntlet. Let's see if this alt gauntlet is going to be required. Unfortunately, not a required alt gauntlet at the harp spot. Just a crystal sword. And I say just a crystal sword because we haven't seen a Cecil yet.
Well, the good thing was, I guess you could say, you know, that Kefka rendition was very nicely done. So, you know, got to take the positive out of it.
Yeah, for those who don't know, a number of the harp music for Free Enterprise was done by community member Tom Lamity.
Meanwhile, you know, poor Commander just running into, you know, literal wall with this evil wall here. You know, just feel for him that he just can't just seem to just get through this.
Yeah, just getting a lot of tough damage, getting some, you know, just some bad RNG, I feel like, too. Not able to get the blinks up and keep them up.
I mean, what's your strategy now at this point if you're, you know, if you're a commander to try to get, to try to push past this spot? I mean, the nukes are working, but, you know, if you take Fu, which I don't know if he even has blink, but, you know, if you take Fu away from doing nuke, then that's less damage you're doing, you know, but I'm just struggling to try to think of an alternative strategy to get through this.
Yeah, I checking the battle speed, making sure that is lower so that you get more input time. I haven't seen if Commander has been adjusting his battle speed or not. It looks like he's probably going to be heading out to Eblin. That's going to be his next big, huge infusion of XP. I don't believe Rosa is the one that has blink, so he'd really like to have two blinkers instead of just one, is all possible. So that's probably where he's heading to just go and do some trap chests here.
All right, we're seeing a Zoe going to Giant here. Now, what do you think's happening here? Is this for, you know, an infusion of you know, XP from either elements or the last spot, or do you think we're going to see, you know, one of those D machine grinds possibly?
I would be betting on D machine. Two fully powered foos. Having weak wants to probably get a third nuke caster, can do so with this Rydia. Zoe has kept Rydia down for most of the seed, so I believe Rydia is definitely within slingshot range.
So there is a manipulation to set up the D machine grind. Zoe, you know, I don't believe choosing to do that, but I'm not sure. Do you want to explain A, what, you know, be doing, and then, you know, B, what's involved in the D machine grind?
Yeah, so there are two ways to manipulate. Thanks to the Highway to the Threemas Zone using the E Can't Run flag, a couple of community members were able to find a manipulation that does not involve running away from the giant fights. So you can do some fights outside of Baron, follow a little chart, and determine, you know, where the next fight is going to be. Is going to be a D machine. That was the new way. And what Zoe did was, I believe, the old way, where just coming up and running away from fights and just happened to get it really quick. As Dathis pointed out, the E Can't Run method was done by Twisted Flax in Simbu. And the old way was found way back in the vanilla speedrun, I believe.
Now, the question I have is, you know, how do you know that you're going to be getting a D machine from a searcher and not, say, you know, I'm trying to remember the other Horseman, yes. Yeah, the horseman. How do you know you're not going to be getting a horseman instead?
So that's where it, being able to interpret these two charts is what's important. So for the old step chart, you're looking for a green circle. If you and these charts are linked in the Discord and on the wiki in various ways. So that's where you want to look and get like a green circle, or it'll tell you how many more encounters until you get the right one. Same for Twisted Flax and Simbu's method too. It'll tell you, you know, take a couple more fights outside of Baron because they're real easy to kill those guys, and then go into the giant. And they've done all the hard work for you. As long as you can read and interpret the chart correctly, then you can get the right grind fight to be able to get to your dragon killing senses and, you know, rack up all the XP that you would need for this seed.
Absolutely. You know, doing that is the easy part, I would say. You know, out of the two, you still have to actually execute this D machine grind, which, you know, people can sometimes make it look very easy. It can go south very quickly on you if you're not careful.
Yeah, like we have Zoe in this position right now where the three alive characters for V are, you know, low health, and looks like Zoe's not doing very many, only did about three or four. So the flame attack from D machine is a percent based attack, so Zoe's not worried about the party really just dying from that, as long as, you know, the health gets put out and stuff like that. So getting the timing, getting, you know, understanding your party's agility and your party's turn order are really the keys to having a successful D machine grind.
Yes, and as Chad is pointing out, V does have 10 key items. So like you said, didn't need that many D machines, you know, picked up, what was that, over 500,000 experience, enough to, you know, pretty much get everyone online to get the levels you need.
Yeah, Zoe actually did a lot of work compiling a grind calculator to, you know, get, you know, it takes into account if you have 10 key items, if you have a slingshot available, and all that. So not surprised that Zoe knew exactly how many D machines that were needed.
Yeah, so now we're going to see who is in this element spot. We see there is a Lunar Sparkle.
Oh, there's a number of bosses here I would not want to fight even with a fully powered team.
Well, I would say Lunar Dragons would be chief among them.
Yeah, and with the sparkles that we've seen, you were not getting Pale Dim there. We've already seen Pale Dim. That was at the Mist Cave. We already fought Plague. So all the bad Lunar Sparkles were the ones that were available.
And, you know, that spot has, what, roughly 100,000 HP. So, you know, that's split between those two. So that's a lot of HP to try to chew down. You know, luckily Giant is not required here. So get your levels and just get out.
Yeah, there is a way to, you know, kill the Lunar Dragons and make them harmless. You have to be able to weather some punches and, you know, make sure that you're counting to try and get those D Lunars to use their breath attack, which, if you can reflect that back on them, will turn them into frogs and make them a whole lot easier to be able to nuke down at that point. But you got to get to that point. I believe it's like 8 hits that you got to get through, plus a couple of flame breaths.
Yeah, that's not pleasant, you know, and for something that's not required when you already got your levels, you know, what's the point?
And with only needing an adamant rock and a baron key and a rat tail, Zoe is heading into the moon.
Well, you've done your grind, you've gotten your levels. This is certainly the you know, this is this check that makes the most sense, has the most checks out of it. You're going to be able to pretty much steamroll through most anything that's down here. as we see Commander going in again for another chance at that evil wall. Hopefully this time we'll be able to pull that through with that, picking up that second foe.
And Poorly Drawn Bees is going to give us another reprisal of the harp music. And with that that second round of music taken up, Commander Leonhart has gotten through the evil wall.
Yes, glad to see that. That's a huge weight off his shoulders. Scythe Marshal decided to go for that demist in the Fey March. Unfortunately, only rewarded with Artemis arrows.
Does have the second demist check still, though, so we'll be hopefully getting a peek at that here as Zoe is just finishing up with Mylon Zed.
Yep, about get ready to look at these two checks, which are Dragoon Spear and a Baron Key.
That's a required Ribbon Altar.
Yes, it's always good when, it always feels good when Moon is required. The last thing you want to see or hear is Moon is haunted.
Commander doing his objectives, climbing the tower, going to be rewarded with the Pan and the Twin Harp. Ooh, there's a free fight there.
Yeah, Zoe rewarded with a nice free fight.
Meanwhile, Poorly Drawn Bees has given us a look at the Dwarf Castle.
That's right. I don't think any of our runners have gone to Dwarf. And there's a Kainazo in that first spot. I don't think should be too threatening here.
No, not when we got the Nuke and Fooze. Gonna make really short work of this.
We do have Calamari Part 2 on Commander's side.
Another Crystal Sword and not a Cecil in sight. That is Pepita. I believe that is our third crystal sword that has been found. There's one in Castle Evelyn.
Yeah, you hate to see that. You really do. I mean, it's just, you know, at that point, you almost just want that Cecil just so you can say you can use one of those crystal swords, because you can't even, you know, if you had an edge, you can't even throw them.
Cocoa shop is required. Moonblaze, I missed if Scythe checked the D-mist.
And Zoe, finding that Golbez at that mass immunity spot, this has a lot of magic attack power. If you don't have walls or star veils, you're going to be in for a very rough time at this spot.
Has the adamant armor on that Rydia, so that's why Rydia is not being held right now. And we got Commander Leonhard is done with the top of the tower. I missed who the character was for poorly drawn bees. Our reshaper pointing out it was Kane.
Well, nice to see, but you know, not this not this late in the seed, I would think.
Haven't seen too much in the way of Kane weaponry either. I know we have a lot of Kane fans out there, and he can be great early game, but you got to get him his weapons. And oh, that's a...
Yeah, that's a... I'm sorry to cut you off. Bees, rewarded with that, pass for remembering that warp glitch is on.
And as Moonblaze is reminding me of the White Spear in the Treasury, and as poorly drawn bees is getting an Avenger.
Well, do you now maybe, slingshot that cane just to use that Avenger?
Oh, Zoe getting a curse string from Golbez as Scythe Marshal got the Magma Key from D-Mist. There was no other way underground to other than through that evil wall.
Well, you on one hand, you hate to see it. On the other hand, you say, all right, well, this is the only way. So everyone had to do it. Everyone had to bear the brunt of it.
So there are still three checks on the moon. Zoe is chasing for objectives.
Yeah, I like the play. You're leaving checks on the moon, but you know you have that Baron key in play. At the very least, it's getting an objective done. You know, maybe you can pick up a, rat tail or, pick up an adamant, but it's an objective if nothing else.
Me personally, I probably, with the levels Zoe's got and just gonna blow through everything with three nukes, I probably would have full cleared the moon. At least for one more key item. We found the Baron key up there, and I think that's the only key item we found up on the moon.
I think Zoe's of the... mindset, and correct me if I'm wrong, who maybe likes to gamble, maybe likes to face check to say, I could play the safe route, but if I'm going for the win, you just gamble and just go for your objectives and just see if you get lucky.
Commander's gonna go give Yang a bonk on the head, and poorly drawn bees is checking out the Fey March.
All And we see the MAGA sisters impersonating the king tonight.
This is going to be real quick, a couple quicks, and these sisters will not be reflecting spells back in anybody anytime soon. Now, it would be interesting if Zoe does some of these last character checks and, you know, a Cecil comes up. I don't know if he has sold any of those crystal swords or not.
Well, fortunately, unfortunately for Vay, it's just a Cid. And yes, very quickly decides, I want nothing to do with that Cid this late in the race.
Question chat. Yes, Woo Bear, Zoe did leave the Crystal Sword Altar as well.
Oh, and we have bees going after that that Bigan. That should be very interesting.
Yeah, this is a scary spot. Bigan punches a lot. You got to get the quakes off to get those arms down, and I think it's going to take two quakes to do it.
Yeah, the problem is Bigan revives those arms very quickly. So they're not, I mean, you know, that was not even a turn and those arms are already back up.
Yep, there was the adamant rock was behind those MAGA sisters.
Well, maybe do you get lucky, you know, all the way and now pull the rat tail out of the basement?
Oh, that would be that would be interesting to pull this rat tail out of this required spot here.
I don't know about you. That does not tend to be my luck. My luck is it's everywhere that you haven't looked. But that would be amazing for the, you know, for V if they could pull that off. I would love to see it.
The nope rope though here, gonna be throwing some blazes out with these new counters.
Yeah, this is not what you want to see, but you hope maybe you just say, okay, I'll just power through with nukes and just get through it maybe.
And meanwhile, oh, there's the Cecil in the seat.
Yes, Commander giving us a look at that very interesting package sprite. You know, you wonder if, you know, I know Commander is a big fan of Cecil Gobur. I gotta wonder if he's going to, you know, take the time to get that Cecil online.
Hasn't found any of the crystal swords yet, so doesn't know that there are three available to him. So, and judging by the party levels, he'll probably maybe swap out that Porum.
Yeah, swap out that Porum or swap out the Rydia. Yeah, probably the Porum, I would say, if you're going to do it.
Zoe got a Moonveil from that Odin fight.
Well, you can't have it all.
Now the question is, where is Zoe gonna go next?
Well, you have Zot, but it looks like you know, either going down to the forge that you know, Legend Sword. It is a required objective anyway.
And poorly drawn bees is still working through this Bigan, handling Bigan very well. I would say personally.
Yeah, I would agree. Honestly, I thought, you know, she would have taken a wipe from now, just based on the way their, you know, her party was looking. But no, she's handling herself very quite well.
And it looks like we have, you know, French Vanilla, Water Hag. Same town, different building.
Yeah, that qualifies as French Vanilla. You know, he decided to get inside, get out of the elements. I don't know.
Got tired of playing in the Oasis.
Right.
Looks like Scythe Marshal is going to be gearing up to do the double key item check at Dwarf Castle. And so is Zoe.
What did we get from these two checks? I'm trying to remember.
The Pass and the Avenger.
Well, the pass alone, I would think, is worth it. You know, just avoid that long, long walk down to Z.
A 100% agree, especially since Zoe left some of those checks up there on the moon, and we'll have to, if the rat tail is on the moon, we'll have to come back, and we'll be right there next to Troya. So that pass is very invaluable.
And as Chet points out, you know, the real prize in the Trader Kane.
And Poorly Drawn Bees is through, and maybe we can see what this bike and Leviathan is holding.
Ugh. Wrong that, tail.
That's still an adamant armor, though.
That's true. That is an adamant armor.
Commander is heading to give our third rendition of music with the Alt Gauntlet, and a crystal sword will be his reward.
Well, we'll be very much vindicated for taking that Cecil. You know, I knew there was no way he wasn't not going to take that Cecil, and this is just going to further solidify it.
Yeah, as Moonblaze pointed out, the number of places we can find this rat tail are getting pretty slim now. We are down to just Zot or the three checks left on the moon.
Yeah, if I'm one of these runners, I'm really hoping it's behind Zot. I want nothing to do with going back to the moon to check those other spots.
And as I said earlier, we do have 21 runners in this race tonight, and we had our first place winner with X Pancras coming, completing the seed in 1 hour, 16 minutes, and 37 seconds. GG's to X Pancras for being our first place winner.
Yes, GG to Pancras. Very nice to finish this seed. So then, you know, knowing that, where do you think that rat tail is then? Do you think it's on the moon, or do you think it's through Zot?
I would probably say Zot. That's gonna be my guess.
Yeah, that wasn't a that wasn't a question where I expected to have an answer. I would have no clue, to be honest. I would say Zot too, but I could also see it being on the moon. You know, if they decided to check everything there, maybe they got rewarded with the rat tail.
Scythe Marshal's going to be following Commander Leonhard as we speculate where this rat tail is going to be. Zoe's going to be clearing out this Fey March with three nukes going out. And three quakes for that Bigan.
Yep, should make pretty quick work of this.
And with the Porum's levels, I might have considered maybe taking one of the Sids or even the Cane just to be an anchor. Those base levels are going to be, I believe, a little bit less agility than this Porum with the amount of levels, I believe about 15, 16 levels.
Well, the good thing is with this flag set, you know, this week, you know, I believe the week before it was, you know, once you dismiss the character, you couldn't retrieve it. Correct me if I'm wrong, but, you know, here you can go back to Mysidia. You can retrieve one of those characters and, you know, get your agility anchor.
Yeah, the C-by flag is not on, so those the characters we left behind and didn't want to bring into the party are just waiting in Mysidia to try and get a chance. This has been the Tufu show, though, so that's why we probably won't see too many other characters hop onto this train.
No, in fact, we have what Commander's the only one that is, you know, well, that really dived that package and picking up that Cecil.
We got poorly drawn bees over cracking some eggs, getting some levels.
Yeah, it's a quick way to get your levels, you know, especially if you have those 10 key items. You know, I would much rather do this than try to do a D machine grind. I mean, you have sirens to buy, you could just get through it and get through it quickly.
Zoe getting some reflected nukes in on this Bigan.
Oh, and Zoe is through that Bigan. Commander doing a fist pump, I'm sure, as he happily throws that crystal sword on that Cecil.
And should he choose to go after that Bigan, we'll be able to find the second adamant armor if he can dig up that earth crystal too.
Absolutely. Very interesting. This is the, you know, bees is just now raising the big whale. I don't know if I, you know, picked up on that until now.
Yeah, bees is gonna be making her first trip up to the moon, as Zoe is getting this Demas, hoping for the rat tail. Just gonna get the magma key. Where does Zoe go, moon or Zot?
Oh, you're going to Zot, I think, no question. You're already on the, you're already on Earth. You know, you have the party. Although, where they're flying, you know, I could be dead wrong. Maybe they are going right to the moon.
And that is, looks to be exactly where Zoe is going. Gonna be heading back to the moon. It'll be interesting to see if K-Value is up first.
Yeah, you have K-Value. You know, you do have that. What was that? That did we see who was that K-Value? Was that?
It's that Valvalis.
The Valvalis. That's right. you know, if you're a viewer, you want to see it. You want to see how someone gets through it. But Zoe will not be going to, or I'm sorry, I was looking at bees. Zoe will be going to Vave Cave Value, will be checking out that Valvalis, and we'll see how that goes.
Moonblaze is pointing out this Val is nukeable.
Yeah, so I guess it just depends on how hard Val's going to hit. I mean, with those weeks coming out too, that's, you know, that can be pretty irritating.
Yeah, this will just be nuking 30,000 XP. Zoe wants none of that Val, though.
Oh, and speaking of an interesting choice, Commander deciding to go with that Kane at Dwarf Castle.
He is not going to hate that decision here in a second. And that's just because of that that Avenger. Billy Drum Bees is getting a little bit more XP, is taking a Warlock fight. This is not a Siren fight that you may see this late, but I do like it, especially in like the mid game, because these Warlocks are not that hard. Easily can use a Mute Knife to knock them out, get some life glitches on them, and it could be a really good early infusion of XP.
Yeah, absolutely. Like you said, getting those life glitches off, I actually have never done a Warlock grind, so I'd be very curious to see how much XP you're going to be getting from 10 key items and 2 life glitches.
It's over 100k. It is definitely a good amount. And also, one of the things that's not in my repertoire that I really need to add is, you know, doing life twos on some of these fights to get even more XP to be able to just continually kill them more and more.
That is an interesting one. That is not one I am personally familiar with.
Yeah, while life one doesn't bring the monster back to life, I believe the life two does. And chat will correct me if I'm wrong. I already admitted I don't know how to do life two stuff all that well. But you still get the XP for killing it, and then you just get to kill it again.
All right, and as chat points out, life two does bring them back with full HP. So that is something I never knew. That's very interesting.
It does take a little bit of timing with the life two cast time and all that. But it is definitely worthwhile, especially if some of your grinds are limited. And while we were talking about Life 2 glitches, we did have our second place winner, PK4787 has come in second place with an official time of 1 hour, 26 minutes, and 31 seconds. GG's to PK.
Yes, GG to PK.
I did not find the rat tail, it looks like, at the Murasame altar, so heading to the Crystal Sword.
Now, is this our first Zot check here with Skype, Marshall?
Yes, it was.
Making very quick work of that Odin with one nuke.
Could this be the elusive rat tail?
Now, they have the ability to complete objective one. They still need that Baron, Baron key, though.
Just a white robe and Zot.
Well, white shirt is nice. I think it's a tier 7 item, but certainly not the item you want to see here.
And that's a vanilla wyvern. Tavis.
All right, then.
Could this be a required vanilla wyvern?
We can certainly hope so.
Looks like Zoe got some walls up, so just gonna be bouncing some nukes, taking Wyvern's own tactic.
Yeah, should be through this fight pretty quickly, even with the reflected nukes on V side.
One of the lower HP spots on the moon, so it's not surprising this Wyvern is down so quickly.
Oh, and there is our objective. There we are. Zoe is in officially go mode.
Just needs to hop back to Earth, turn it in, gonna get another adamant as well, and we'll be heading on over to the Z fight.
And if Bees makes it through this, she'll be the next one to pick up the rat tail and get the good news.
Yeah, Bees doesn't know that that Baron key is going to give her the adamant for go mode, though. So may probably finish cleaning out the moon.
Yeah, I mean, that goes to your point earlier. You know, you talked about where, you know, your play would have been to clear out the moon if you're Zoe. You know, here, it would have been the right choice to make. That's just one of those things as a runner that, you know, it sometimes hindsight's always 20/20. You know, the right check is sometimes the ones, you know, you don't make.
And as Zoe's going to go turn in some tails, we do have our third place winner. Jeebus just came in third with an official time, 1 hour, 30 minutes, and 43 seconds. So GG's to Jeebus.
GG to Jeebus.
Zoe now has Crystal in hand.
Gets a Luka key, so that's 17 out of 17 for V. Now I'm going to be picking up that adamant, and I imagine we'll be flying right to Troia to, you know, start the final leg of this journey.
Poorly drawn Bees is heading right to that ribbon room, wants to get that that twofer. And we're gonna be seeing our first restream runner gonna be heading into the Seromas fight, I believe. After a little bit of inventory management.
Yep, one of Free Enterprise's other favorite bosses is inventory management.
So we got some flags going, and since this is your first time doing commentary, Lady SSJ, do you want to do the honors of explaining what these flags are?
Boy, I'm gonna take a stab at this. You feel free to correct me if I'm wrong. So, goodness, we're seeing a lot of Z flags in chat, as you point out. So, you know, the reason is Zeromas is too nasty, too strong. To be put anywhere else. You know, the entire game is randomized. They're not gonna put Zeromas anywhere else. Having random big bangs thrown out is not something anybody wants. However, the sprite for Zeromas is randomized and can be one of, I wanna say between 500 and 600 different sprites, I wanna say. So when you use the crystal on him, he'll turn into one of those many, many sprites that are all done, between Scala and I believe one or two other members of the community. And They're all amazing.
And it usually comes with a question that we'd like to ask.
And that is, whose butt are we going to kick tonight?
I have not seen a Z-Sprite that I have not enjoyed. They are all fantastic. And who do we have? I am at a loss. Little Griffiths?
I want to say I recognize it, but I would be lying if I said if I knew.
It is definitely cute. I want one as like a plushie.
Yes, indeed. Oh, Little Grimm from Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. Okay. Yes, now I can see it.
This is the first time I've seen this sprite, and it's been it's a great looking sprite too, especially pulling it from one of the Game Boy Advance games.
Yes, indeed. Tactics, you know, Tactics Advance was, you know, a pretty good game in its own right, and it's nice to see it get some love here.
So for those who don't know some of the mechanics of the Zeromus fight, Zeromus has 120,000 XP or HP, but the game can't count that high. So after 45,000 damage is done, Zeromus will counter with an HP refill. One of the other mechanics of Final Fantasy IV, though, is a counter will not fire if you reflect a spell and do the damage. So this is a good way to make the Zeromus fight really quick, to only have to do half the amount of damage by just reflecting these spells. And with three nuke casters and a white caster, this Zeromus is not long for this world.
Absolutely not. And then, you know, in the middle of that, we had Poydrak coming in fourth place with a time of 1 hour and 35 minutes and 18 seconds. So GG to Poydrak.
Poorly Drawn Beast did come back down to Earth, turning in her tails. Could be heading over to Baron to, you know, possibly get her crystal as well.
Well, knowing that it is a required, objective, I would certainly think. Or you could go down, you know, to underground first. I don't know, you know, if there's a faster play.
And it looks like Scythe Marshall's going to be heading up to the moon. Zoe not worried about a heal. Gonna go right with the white cast, go with the new cast, try and get this Zeromus down.
It's a risky play, but, you know, at this point, I don't think it's necessarily the bad play to make if you know you've done enough damage.
Is this the nuke that does it?
It is indeed the nuke that does it. Zoe Vermillion finishes fifth place, the time of 1 hour, 37 minutes, and 20 seconds. Our first restreamer tonight to finish. GG's to Zoe.
GG's, and we will see about getting Zoe in for an interview. Sounds like we're joined. GG's, Zoe.
Hey, thanks, GG's.
Yes, GG's.
How you feeling about that seed?
Bread. No, I'm feeling pretty good. I can identify the time losses pretty quickly. Moon Harp was a gamble, but I got it from the top of tower, so I figured might as well try it. Bailing on Moon early kind of bit me, and it bit me in a way that I didn't like, because At that point, I was looking for Baron Key, Adamant, Rattail. So I found the Baron Key. I was like, all right, let me finish up the bottom of the moon, and then I'll go do Baron. And if I get Adamant or Rattail there, I'll stay on the Earth to try and find the other. And if not, I'll just come right back to the moon. And so when I found that Adamant, I was like, all right, cool, let's go find the Rattail. But the next stop on the moon for me would have been Crystal Sword Altar. So I was a little bummed about that. But, you know, 17 out of 17 in less than an hour and 40, I'll take that.
That's a fantastic time for, you know, a full clear, essentially. So very well done, Race. You were the first one through the evil wall. What were your thoughts in seeing that at the Rucante spot?
I have two foods with Nuke. This is fine. Yeah. If I had gone there earlier, or if I hadn't gotten lucky enough to get Nuke as early as I did, I would have been a little more scared. Especially because I also didn't have Weak, so the idea of maybe doing an early demission grind to get through a nasty hook route wasn't on the table. But fortunately, I didn't have to consider that.
Yeah, that was a very, very well done race. Like you said, I mean, getting 17 and 17 as quickly as you did, even having to come back down to the moon a second time, I mean, just a fantastic race all around. That was a real joy to watch.
Well, thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure to race. It's always a pleasure to be featured on the restream. It's always a pleasure to come in just behind some people that I really respect. Everybody that finished ahead of me is someone that on one of my good days, I would not bet on myself to win. So coming in fifth in this race, that feels pretty good.
Yeah, you should feel good. It, like I said, it was a joy to watch, you know, just making short work of a ton of fights, and there were a good number of rude ones. That Golbez, just give it a curse ring for that. I mean,
yeah, talk about a cursed spot. Jeez, I was like, all right, no, let's just reset out of that. Like, fortunately, it wasn't a huge time sink because I had Adamant Armor, Crystal Ring, Rydia, so it wasn't a huge deal. But yeah, no, this was a lot of fun, and I think probably my favorite part of this was the Dark Elf on Hobbs with my two grimoires pulling Indra followed by an Odin. I bet there's some people in chat who didn't know that Odin could kill Dark Elf too.
We had some fun with that. That was a hilarious moment. You know, I didn't even realize you had a second grimoire, and then I look over at your screen and see the Odin come through and just and just cackle. That was amazing.
I want your grimoire luck. That's what I want.
So, you know, you don't, because this is an anomaly. There's been times where I've needed my grimoire to get through the antlion cave, and I had to reset four times because I got four chocobos in a row. So, no, I'll keep my luck. Thank you. You can have whatever yours is. It's better than mine.
No, because I've had that exact same one. It was probably the same race, too.
Probably. But yeah, thanks to Dathis for the restream. I think I only spied two bits of vanilla. I think it was the Cid in Baron Castle and then that Wyvern there at the end. You got to step up your game. I'm coming for your crown, friend. And then thanks to Blaze doing the tracking. And then you two doing the comms. Can't wait to watch it back. I'm really excited to hear your first comm assignment. I still don't know a short version to call you because there's like four parts to your name.
Yeah, there's only about four or five different variations. Lady SSJ or Lady X Gears, you know, I say whichever's easier for people, you know, to do, that's fine. I'm not picky. But yes, thank you very much, you know, for being on here and for being on my first comm. It was, you know, definitely very entertaining.
Yeah, happy to have you on the Restream team. Happy to have you in the community. And if anybody out there in chat wants to join the community, maybe get in on some of these races or even join our Restream team, check out the Discord. I'm going to plug it. Hopefully someone's in chat putting it right now because I'm not currently in chat. So.
It was put in.
Awesome. Cool. Well, I'm going to hop off. Good luck to the rest of the racers. Thanks again. Y'all are awesome and y'all rock it. Have a good night.
Thank you, Zoe. That was Zoe Vermillion, our fifth place runner, and we'll probably be joined by Poorly Drawn Bees here soon as she is about to get her crystal.
And, yeah, unfortunately, that Cocoa Shop, I didn't notice till now, had, you know, not much in the way to offer.
I do want to welcome the raid from Randomania. Welcome. This is our Monday night community race of Final Fantasy IV Free Enterprise.
Yes, welcome to all of you. You know, we have four racers going tonight. We did have one just finished, but we still have three. One is about to go to their Zeromus fight. So, you know, hopefully tune in and like what you see.
Yep, poorly drawn bees, pass in hand, heading over to Troia to start up her Zeromus fight. And it looks like Scythe Marshal got that Baron Key and headed back down to Earth, but might not have done the Crystal Sword Altar to get that rat tail.
Yeah, probably hoping for, you know, getting the rat tail here. Of course, like you said, doesn't know the news that the rest of us know that, you know, rat tail's back on Moon. You know, like I said, if this were me, I would probably have made the same move that Zoe and Scythe did. But, you know, unfortunately, it's the wrong move.
And Commander Leanheart going to be rewarded with his white shirt, has his crystal sword, has his adamant, because I did see him loot the treasury. Gonna be really happy with a Cecil that goes burr.
Yes, he is not at all gonna be, you know, disappointed with that. As poorly drawn bees is going to her Z fight, about to throw the crystal on to see be greeted by that wonderful sprite.
Yeah, not as many nuke casters for poorly drawn bees, just the foo. So gonna be relying on probably an Avenger Kane and a Berserk Yang.
Yeah, with their levels, I can't imagine that, you know, even if that foo goes down, you still have that Rosa 2800 HP. I don't think it's going to have any trouble getting through this. It's not going to be as speedy as Zoe's run is, you know, just with the, you know, reflected nukes. You're going to have to chew through all of Zeromus's, you know, HP, but still don't think we'll be, you know, shouldn't be much of a trouble.
No, and one of the things that people kind of look down on Yang for is, you know, his early game is kind of weak. But as you just saw, Yang just needs levels and can punch. You know, give Yang some levels and he'll do some damage for you.
Absolutely. I mean, even if you don't Zerk him, if you just, you know, if J abilities are on and you can, you know, get a power off from him, you know, you can push out 5, 6K from him. You know, so now, Yang is not one to necessarily sleep on, especially with that high HP pool.
Yeah, and a Zerk Yang in this fight is going to go fast, probably faster than somebody casting nukes, so, and less animation.
As we get that first big bang coming through. Nerf, so you know, Sid does go down, but you know, we're looking in pretty good shape.
Yeah, and Commander Leanheart making the dive into the moon. We'll see if he stops after hitting the Ribbon Room, or if we'll do the Crystal Sword Altar. Zoe, the Cecil was in the package.
Yes, but Zoe, Crystal Sword plus Adamant Armor. Cecil go burr.
Yeah, and Commander did the package check pretty early after coming out of the underground. So right before he did the Twin Harp. And we do have our sixth place winner, Jay Brunner, came in sixth with 1 hour, 47 minutes, and 56 seconds. So GG's him. Commander Leonhart planning to make a very short work of this Mylon Z, though, with a Crystal Sword Cecil.
Yep, and even zerking that Rosa up. No need to worry about any of those heals. Yeah, like you said, just gonna tear right through this Mylon Z.
Question for D. Shmoo. This is Lee Grimm from Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. Scythe Marshall is about to get rewarded with his adamant. Looking at what he has left, probably going to have to just turn right around. I believe Scythe Marshall's done most of the checks on Earth. So we'll probably just make a quick U-turn and head right back to the moon.
And we see something that doesn't happen very often where you cast a white on Zeromus, he will counter with weak.
Yep, that is the script for casting a direct light onto Zeromus instead of reflecting it. So that is how he wants to handle that instead of countering with a nuke. But that was Roxxon. That's a bang.
Yep. Emily's poorly drawn bees finished 7th place with a finish time of 1 hour, 49 minutes, and 28 seconds. GG's to poorly drawn bees.
And we will get her in here for an interview.
And we are joined by Poorly Drawn Bees. How's that race for you? How are you feeling?
Did anyone order another 17 out of 17? Because I'm here to deliver.
That seems to be the only thing on the menu that we've seen so far. Both of our restreamers who have finished have gone 17 out of 17.
The one time I didn't rush Moon at like level 19 and this happens.
I mean, that's an hour and 49 minutes on this seed to finish, you know, 17-17. That's pretty good. You had a very good race yourself.
Thank you.
What are your overall thoughts, you know, just on the seed and, you know, seeing Evil Wall down at that, Babel spot? Can't imagine it was, you know, too much trouble, but just curious of your overall thoughts.
Oh, once I had second foo, I was just like, the rest of the seed's free. It's just a matter of finding the things. But, you know, then Rando happened, so...
Yeah, there was some rudeness thrown here or there. The Evil Wall tripped up a couple of people, but you got through it really well. You got through the entire seed really well, actually.
Thanks. Yeah, I think the only real mistakes I made were not cracking enough eggs before Biogen, and then some rallying error, like some movement errors. But yeah, other than that, I'm actually pretty pleased with how I played tonight.
Yeah, 7th place out of 21. You got to be happy with that, especially with the people who have finished already. We have a really good field tonight with how many people who are racing and some really good competition. So you should feel proud about this finish.
Oh, yeah. And if I'm going to finish behind somebody on the stream, like, you know, I am totally okay with finishing behind Zoe. I've heard Zoe's played this game a couple times or something like that.
I mean, just a few.
Just a few.
Just a few.
Yeah, and as you mentioned, you know, getting through that Biogen fight, you know, that Biogen fight was giving you, you know, a bit of a rough go, but you pulled through it, and you know, that alone was pretty fun to watch.
Yeah, as soon as I died the first time, I was like, yeah, I just need to lower the battle speed, maybe use the silk web, I'm good. I don't think I got the silk web off, but I had two sources of Quake, so whatever.
Yeah, it was a number of comments in the chat once you finished that fight were commending you on that. It was that's a tough spot, you know, for a lot of bosses, Biogen especially, and you handled it really well.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad my fans are out there. Just kidding.
So will we see you back on Friday for the run back of these flags?
I cannot say. Depends if I wake up in time.
That is usually a deciding factor for some of us, whether we are awake at that time.
Yeah, it was. I only managed to race this today because I only got 3 hours of sleep. So, especially on 3 hours of sleep, I think I did okay tonight.
That could be the that could be the secret to all your races then.
Well, I feel like I shouldn't degrade my health, but next time it comes up, I will give it a thought.
Definitely take care of the health first.
All right, but only because you said so. All right, well, I think I'm going to head out. Thank you both so much for the interview and everyone for watching me, and I hope to see you all around someday soon.
Thank you, and thanks for being on the restream tonight and putting on a fantastic show for us.
Always glad to be here. Have a great night, everyone.
Have a good night. And as Emily departs, we have our eighth place finisher coming in, Roger McBain, the time of 1 hour, 53 minutes, and 49 seconds. So GG's to Roger.
GG's to him. We've got Commander Leonhart heading down to do the Odin spot as Scythe Marshal just took care of the Mersame altar. Scythe is looking for that rat tail still. Hopefully the next check will be that crystal sword.
Yeah, you have to hope that they're just going to just dive every check on the moon here and just come across it at this point.
Yeah, I do want to point out the early struggles with Commander Leonhart and that evil wall, with him sticking with it and really not being that far behind Scythe Marshal, you know, shows a lot of, you know, resilience to get through the seed.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I know Commander is, you know, team no forfeit. You know, he doesn't want to quit a seed. You know, no one would blame anyone if they ran up against that evil wall and said, you know what, I not tonight. It's a little much to handle. But yeah, Commander, you know, licked his wounds, regrouped, got some levels, got through it, and really it's been kind of smooth sailing since then. So yeah, good for him.
Just unleashing that crystal sword, Cecil, on everything else, and sitting back on Easy Street, I think.
Oh, goodness, yeah. I mean, the crystal sword Avenger, yeah. Oh, it just makes just quick work of everything. I mean, it's a nice reward after having to suffer through that evil wall.
Yep. Scythe Marshal is making the climb up to the crystal sword altar, not going to check the Ogopogo spot or the White Spear altar. I'm not sure if he checked those already, but is going in to make the right play now.
Yes, we'll have to get through this Wyvern, but, you know, Star Veil goes up. Here comes another Star Veil. Well, going got the one off. But, yeah, he still had that Fu and Rosa survived, so, yeah, shouldn't be a problem.
Yeah, this Crystal Sword Altar has very low magic to account for how strong this Mega Nuke is. So that's why you'll see a lot of low rolls and a lot of higher HP parties just, you know, shrug it off.
Yeah, kind of the one and only time where you see Wyvern with an opening Mega Nuke and don't immediately shriek out loud.
Why won't my Mega Nuke do anything?
Even that nuke couldn't even pull off 400 HP on that Rydia.
Looks like something has caught Commander Leonhart's eye here in the cocoa shop. Wants some of those apples, it looks like. Oh, you got another crystal sword you can sell, Leonhart. Actually, he may not. He's probably got the Avenger equipped currently.
Yeah, he may have only picked up the one. But yeah, really diving into those apples.
Do have our ninth place finisher with Microcorks coming in at 1 hour, 58 minutes and 0 seconds. GG to Microcorks.
Yep, GG to Microcorks.
And with this rat tail in hand, Scythe Marshal will be in go mode here shortly after paying a visit to the grotto. And do want to point out, as we have some retracing going on, we do have another run of these flags on Friday at 10 p.m. Eastern. If you have been watching and say, you know, I'd be interested in maybe doing this, you should come out, join the race, maybe be on the restream even to give this flag set a go.
Yeah, you know, the flags were tuned down a little bit to be a little bit more, you know, newbie accessible. You know, requires still a little bit knowledge of the game, but it the flags aren't harsh. You know, with that T Wildish flag, you're getting some good loot. You know, maybe it could still take you a little time to clear it, which is fine, but you know, unless you run into a super rude boss like that evil wall, you know, generally, you know, you're gonna find that you're gonna be able to clear it and, you know, have a good time while you're doing it.
Scala reminding me that the Friday night race is going to be on the Randomania channel. I believe it's going to be Randomania 2 this week, I think, if I saw the schedule right.
Commander going for that Valvalus.
The one check we haven't seen yet.
Poor Cecil still getting hit with that weak. But oh my goodness, 7,500 from that Cecil with that Avenger on is just too good.
And as Commander Leonhard is working on this vow, Scythe Marshal is heading into the Zeromus fights.
And Commander getting through that Valvalus fight, going to be giving us a look at that check. And is going to be rewarded with a Masamune, so, you know, something to sell, but he decides to reset out of it, and rightfully so.
We could have had a fully equipped edge with Masamune and Murasame if we had just taken him from Zami.
Yep, unfortunately, he's just going to have to settle with Avenger Crystal Sword, Admin Armor, Cecil. You know, really living the poor life.
You mean the dream? That's my goal for every seed, even if no adamants is turned on.
Oh, absolutely. That is totally my dream too. Avenger Crystal Sword. That's the dream.
We got the crystals coming out. We're going to have, looks like, another reflected spell party for Scythe Marshal.
Yeah, you can see that Cid get up to 4,800 HP. I don't know if, you know, I imagine he'll just be doing reflect strats here, so maybe Cid won't see some work except maybe early on to maybe chip away at that initial, you know, 65,000-ish HP, but, you know, with those foos at that HP level, should be getting through this also with no issue.
Got the silk web out a little early. That is one thing to watch for with some of these low agility situations. If you go a little fast, your silk web could be wasted. And that's why we're seeing some manual cast slows here.
Yeah, absolutely. The silk web works as a double slow. If you don't get a silk web off, or if you don't have access to silk web, you will need to do two casts of slow in order to achieve the same effect. And you know, as you rightfully point out, you have to time it right. You know, you don't want to just throw out the silk web the second Zeromus morphs into a sprite. Otherwise, you're gonna unfortunately mess with it.
But Scythe does have the slows all set up, has the star veil up, here's the first big bang, and now the nukes and the whites will fly.
Yep, and manages to get those slows off, to nerf the damage of that big bang. So yeah, we'll just be going right into their reflex strats, and hopefully we can be smooth sailing from here.
Yeah, the first big bang is the easiest. It has the biggest window because you can do it at any time in the early phase of the fight to get that nerf done. The subsequent big bangs are a little trickier. There's a number of guides out there that I should probably read one of these days on how to reliably nerf big bangs. But a number of runners, myself included, just try to shoot for, hey, let's try and get it before that second big bang comes out. So, Do give some of our guides a read, though. They have been able to save a number of runners' Zeromus fights by knowing when to nerf some of these big bangs.
Oh, absolutely. There's all in these comprehensive docs. There's so many little details that you can pick up on. You can watch races, for months, and you'll pick up a lot of great information, but the comprehensive docs will really help fill in the gaps in your knowledge. They're such a great resource.
I still learn things. I've been playing this game since it came out, and I still learn new things when I play.
Oh, absolutely. I've been involved in the, racing for, a couple months now, and I probably only know a quarter of, everything that this randomizer has to offer, let alone not even just the game. There's things about the game that I've learned just from the randomizer.
And our restreamer Dathus pointing out that he found out about the Lunar Frog strategy from Free Enterprise. Will this nuke do it? Should be pretty close with how much magic is going out. Oh, that was a real high roll there.
That was a high roll. And with that, Scythe Marshall finishes 10th place with a time of 2 hours and 6 minutes and 3 seconds. GG to Scythe.
And we will see about getting him in here for an interview.
And meanwhile, we wait on Scythe to come in. Commander does get the good news that rat tail's there. Sure is very happy. Immediately exits out of that moon, and we'll be heading back in to turn his rat tail in and get his go mode going.
Gonna be rewarded with the second adamant if he hasn't already turned in that pink tail.
Yep, nice little consolation prize to get.
And we are joined by Scythe Marshall. GG's. Scythe, are you able to hear us?
While we wait, You know, on that, kind of nerdy housewife finishes in 11th place with a time of 2 hours and 8 minutes, pretty much on the dot.
Commander's Goddess Crystal in hand, gonna be zipping right over to Troia. Bear with us, we are trying to get Scythe Marshal. We do have a little technical difficulty going on.
Commander going for that off not seen black chocobo in the Baron Chocobo Forest. Wonder if because no, maybe just doing it just to be a man of the people.
Hello.
Hey, there we got Scythe Marshal. GG's.
Thank you.
Oh, thoughts on your run? GG on your completion?
Well, I executed Reflex Strats successfully without botching them. I did have to go to battle speed 4, but I only saw one big bang, so that was nice. And I thought, honestly, I played pretty well. I just got 17 out of 17.
That seems to be the order of the day, though. Both of the previous restream runners who completed also went 17 out of 17, and Commander Leonhardt, the fourth one, also did.
Ah, I see. Great.
Yeah, but no, I mean, you ran a pretty good race. You know, I'm sure probably one of the only disappointing parts was clearing both those Fey March bosses, getting through that mist, and, you know, getting Artemis arrows for your level.
The Artemis arrows weren't so bad because I knew I could get a key item at Rydia's mom. But
yes,
then,
that is true.
I forget what that was. That wasn't good.
This is the magma key.
Oh yeah, the magma key. Yes, the Bygen was obnoxious. I was mildly miffed that I got through the Bygen fight and did not get anything for my troubles. But that was fun. Quake is a good spell if you remember to cast it on all three of the components of Bygen and not just one of them.
Yeah, that Bygen was definitely some rudeness that I'm glad that I was in the commentators before and not playing against.
I believe that, yes.
Yeah, overall initial thoughts, you know, on the seed and the flag set?
Honestly, it's a pretty friendly flag set. There's a reason it was for the beginner, you know, the beginner bonanza. The routing for it wasn't too bad in the sense of the seed sort of guides you where to go mostly. So routing wise, it wasn't too bad. And so I felt that my, so I saw the early foo. And so I went back to get the second foo from Baron Inn as quickly as possible. And so obviously I you know, there it's on my, I can see it on my game feed. The early foo, and I went back and I got darkness really early and said, okay, that's fine. So that was good. And then, I don't know, I think once I was there, I said, okay, I'm going to grind foo until I get nuke. So I took out a bunch of bosses. And I thought that was the right play because I got nuke fairly early, and then it sort of trivialized the hook route. And then I found Sirens in Cave Evelyn. And so I knew, okay, I'm going to grind a little bit because I didn't have that much money and then do Tower. And then I found the Pan. So I said, okay, let's go do Fey March and then Sylph Cave. And so I thought, like, the routing wasn't too bad. It's just I got unlucky by not going to the moon immediately and clearing all of the bosses there.
Yeah, the play here was go to the moon and, you know, two required key items up there. So you're not punished by not going, you know, with the information you had and clearing more of the K main checks. is definitely a good call anytime you do a seed like this. So it was just, I think, just unlucky that, you know, you got that Baron King. You're like, oh, it's an objective. I want to go clear it out. It's also two checks. And then it led to another required item. I could see where the appeal would be to leave after that point.
Yeah, that is true. That was the one thing that I guess the main mistake I made was fading, I guess, for a little bit, the rest of the moon bosses after I got the Baron Key. Did anyone fight Valvolous at Bahamut spot?
Commander did. Oh, Commander, no. I think the only one on the green stream that did.
What was the reward?
A Masamune.
Masamune.
Well, there was an edge. There was an edge this seed.
Yep, and Commander was the only person who found the Cecil that was at the package.
Oh, interesting. Where? What? Remind me where the package was.
I believe that was the top of Lower Babel, because the pan was from the Tower Key. Oh, Sheila 2. Sorry, our tracker is reminding us it was Sheila 2 who had the package.
Ah, Sheila 2, huh? So that was there. Okay, so I guess the multiple crystal swords this seed could have been used.
We counted three.
Were there three? Oh, great. I only found two. I sold one of them.
Hey, that's establishing dominance on the seed right there.
Yep.
Any other closing thoughts?
Okay. So I said I thought I played pretty well. I got juked by Alt Gauntlet at Cave Magnus, because that is the only, isn't that the only boss at that spot that can be successfully hit by, like, you know, your standard, I guess Nuke can hit through, but most other spells can't hit through that spot's magic defense, except if you have Alt Gauntlet.
Yeah, but then all your spells work.
Yeah, but I explicitly set my party up so that, you know, I could melee it. But I think at that point I had Nuke, so I probably shouldn't have done that. So that was a mistake on my end. There were a bunch of small mistakes, but otherwise I thought it was okay. Just, oh, one more meme. Vanilla Wyvern.
Required Vanilla Wyvern.
That was pretty funny. I threw my Star Veil and then realized, wait, this is vanilla. And then saw my characters get hit for 800 damage.
Well, all in all, it was a good race. You ran really well. 2 hours to full clear the whole thing. That you got to be proud of yourself for that.
Yeah, that wasn't bad. This is my first restream. So I'm glad that I did not disappoint.
Well, we look forward to seeing you on here more.
Wonderful. Thank you to, I think we had Dathis on the restream. I think it was Moonblaze Wolf on tracking, and then Bad Karma and Lady SSJ Excuse. Thank you so much for all of your commentary and, you know, helping the folks who are watching know what's going on.
Thank you as well.
Thank you, and GG's. And we did have Commander Leonhardt finish, so we will be pulling him in here for an interview here shortly. And we're joined by Commander Leonhardt. Commander Leonhardt, GG's.
Thank you.
That evil wall.
That evil wall. You know?
How about that evil wall?
Yeah, that evil wall. You know, there are so many checks to remember. So many things to keep track of that even on a basic exit, it's easy to overlook something. Today, for me, it was Hobbs.
Yeah, the double food and getting Nuke from Ordeals was definitely making that evil wall a lot less scary. I do want to give my hats off to you for sticking through that, and then you know, making up so much time afterwards, though. You blew through the rest of that seed.
Got a little lucky. I felt like at times I got a little lucky, and then I realized at the end I had 17 out of 17 again, and I guess not, but I was definitely in full-on gamble the moment I got through that tower.
Well, I have some news that will make you feel better.
What's that?
Tonight's four-person restream was four 17 out of 17s.
Hey, well, there's that. I guess, given the way it played out, because I'm sitting there, I get through, finally get underground, and I'm like, okay, given all this power, the only people that aren't going to the moon right now are the ones that went there to get ready for that evil wall. So I'm going to clear out the earth as best I can. And when I got the Baron, I immediately ran back. And when I saw the adamant in there, I'm like, oh, I wonder it took people so long. They full cleared the moon before they hit that Baron, I bet.
Yeah, a lot of our restreamers, you know, didn't, surprising, you know, did not, you know, decided to go to Baron, you know, which Bad Karma and I were talking about, you know, debating, do you full clear moon first or do you go to Baron? And turns out full clearing the moon was the right play, but, you know, a lot of people made the gamble to go to Baron instead.
Hey, just to show you that still can't predict meta.
Rando, yes.
Yes, indeed.
But you had to feel, you know, vindicated seeing that Cecil out of the package, knowing that you at least had an X-Cal coming, and with that adamant armor, eventually picking up that crystal sword and Avenger sword, and as it, you know, the meme goes, Cecil goes burr.
Yeah. Also, part of it was full gamble mode. I had been to Feymarch for the freebie and hadn't even looked at the bosses. And when I got the package, I'm like, you know, the one thing that would really save me and completely turn this around would be a D-Mist at package. I didn't realize D-Mist was sitting there in Asura laughing at me, but Cecil proved to be worth it in the end.
So would you have gone to the package if you had seen the D-Mist in Feymarch?
I don't know, honestly, Bad Karma. I'm not sure. I don't know if I'll ever know the answer to that. I probably would have gone for it immediately after checking music, though, so.
Yeah, and having that crystal sword come out of music, we saw three on the restream. There was one in Edwin Castle, and then one of the altars in the bottom of the Lunar Subterranean had one as well.
Nice.
Any of your overall thoughts on the seed, you know, as far as being accessible to, you know, maybe a new player or a newer player, I would say?
Oh, yeah, definitely accessible. You've got the potential for early Foo and Edge. I mean, Evil Wall at Ruby is a rude hook route. Like, there are a lot of rude potential hook routes that's on the list, especially with that party that I was bringing. There wasn't much in the way of swinging. I could have anchored better and made it easier, but given that rudeness, it was still pretty doable. The early Edge, the early Foo, the Wildish, if you know where to loot on that, it's going to be good times. And just straight up have four objectives and go for it. So, yeah, very accessible.
Well, Death has just said in chat, he tried to be nice and gave you two foos. You just had to go find him.
Yeah, you just had to be sensible enough to, you know, check Baron in and check Hobbs. I may have a penchant for baiting both of those places at one time or another.
Well, we'll be seeing you on the run back on Friday.
Yeah, I mean, unless I'm up here in the booth, you know, calling the action, we'll definitely be racing and giving it another run.
Well, I look forward to seeing some more races from you and seeing you back on the restream here shortly.
Thank you. I'm looking forward to hearing you, Bad Karma, and Lady Xenogears on comms. It's going to be great. Athos, nice roll. I like the touches of vanilla. I appreciated finishing off of vanilla at Wyvern. And Moonblaze, I gave you lots of things to light up. I hope you enjoyed it.
Well, thank you for putting on a good show and for putting on a good racehorse.
That's it.
GG's to you.
And with that, our four restream runners have finished. We are going to be kicking this party over to F. Coughlin, one of the community members. He is running Zelda 1 Randomizer. So we will be heading over there. So please show some support to F. Coughlin. Do want to do a quick shout out to Dathis, our restreamer, our tracker, Moonblaze Wolf. I believe that's the only time I've seen all 88 buttons lit up. And for Lady SSJ for joining me in the booth and on a successful first time in commentary.
Yes, with you, Bad Karma, it was a very enjoyable night. Fortunately, we had some very entertaining, runners on the restream, and really made the restream team made my night easy. Everyone knows what they're doing and everyone's super passionate about this community, and it's all great. It's all fun. And I'll definitely be doing this more often.
Look forward to working with you again. And, to everybody else out there in Free Enterprise Channel, you all have a good night. We'll see you over on a Fred stream.
Good night, everyone.